الله نحمده ونستعين به ونسترشده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتدي، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. أوصيكم عباد الله وإياي بتقوى الله، وأحضكم على طاعته، وأنهاكم عن مخالفته، وأستفتح بالذي هو خير، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد, dear brothers and sisters, today I would like to share with you some reflections on مغفرة, on attaining the forgiveness of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, something that is essential in the life of every human being, something that we should always seek as believers in Allah سبحانه وتعالى and strive to attain on a daily basis in every aspect of our action and our deeds. First of all, we must realize that as a human being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us with the will to make mistakes, with the ability to commit sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us imperfect in one sense. So we all commit mistakes. We all need to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala of these mistakes. It's very similar to driving your car. The best, with the best intentions, still people make mistakes and have accidents and create problems for each other. And the same apply to our own lives. We make mistakes and commit sins, whether in our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or in relationship to those around us, when we are talking to other people, when we are dealing with other people, when we are neglecting our duties toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we reflect upon our daily life, we will see that we commit sins, major and minor, and we should always seek forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from these sins. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, كُلُّ بْنِ آدَمَ خَطَّاءَ. All the children of Adam commit mistakes and made mistakes. And the best among them are those who seek to repair these mistakes. So we should not look at this as something that will happen to other people but will not happen to us. We are all committing these mistakes. Some of us may commit minor ones, some of us may commit major ones, but we all are sinners. We all are making these mistakes. No one is better than the other. And if you look at the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, definitely the people who supported the Prophet of Allah, whether it is our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or other prophets, are the best of their generations and of other generations also. And when we look at the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we see that they were as near to being perfect as a human being would be, but they still committed mistakes and committed sins. Seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that Allah mentioned in the Quran many times. He mentioned to us to seek forgiveness, whether it was at the call of Nuh alayhi salam to his people, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. And this is a very subtle and nice reminder. When Nuh alayhi salam, who lived for many years with his people, call upon them to repent and seek forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentioned to them something else. He said to them, إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. And this is a name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Ghaffar, Al-Ghafoor, the one who forgive not on a one-by-one basis, but on a continuous basis. He continuously forgive his people what they have done. So Nuh alayhi salam, when he called upon his people, he said to them, استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا. He will forgive one sin after another. And we see this in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of the Sahaba was continuously making sins. and seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he felt doomed that he is continuously making these mistakes. And then he goes and asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. And he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and told him, this is how I feel. I feel very miserable because I make a sin, then I ask Allah for forgiveness. Then I make this sin again. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Allah forgives your sin. And he said to him, but then I make it again. I go again and make the same sin. And the Prophet said to him, Allah will forgive your sin. And then he said to him, and I continue to do this. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, Allah will not give up unless you give up. As long as you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, He is ready to forgive you. He is willing to forgive you. His door is open always for you. And this is what we should keep in mind. Some of us start drifting away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they do not resort to ask Allah for forgiveness because they think, as long as I am straying away from the path of Allah, I should not ask for His forgiveness. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught the Sahabi and taught every one of us that continuously you should ask Allah for forgiveness. And who knows that one day the words that you are saying with your tongue will touch your heart, will make your feeling tender, and you will indeed seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but for the last time. And you will drift into the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not away from it. You will quit the sins, not that you have done that willingly, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring you to the end of all the misery that you have in your life when you are drifting away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.